Hey everybody, Johnny Laser here again, and today we're going to do what I would consider a beginner-friendly project. What we're going to do is we're going to take this stone here and we're going to engrave on it. Now, my niece bought a house and she had a whole pile of these things, so I told her, I says, hey, I'll take them from you. She wanted to get rid of them, so now I got a whole pile of stones. And what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to make a gift for my neighbor for Christmas because he's been so helpful for me during the year. This year, I had an accident with the shed there where it got flipped over in a tornado. So he helped me write it and everything. And I thought I'd make him a nice gift for the front of his house. We're going to do a house address and home sweet home and make it look real nice. So we will try to get this level when we engrave it. If we can't, then we're going to use curved surface. Now, as I said before, I've done one of these before. I did one for the front of my house, and it's easier than you think. It's a beginner friendly project. Very nice. You can make a lot of things. People will, you know, beloved pet passes away, you can make little headstones for them and all sorts of things, you know, stuff for the garden. Trespassers beware, whatever. All right, so what we're going to do first of all is we're going to paint it black, just like slate. We're going to paint it black and then we're going to come back and we'll do some programming. All right, stick with us. See you in a bit. Hey, well, it's the next day. I've taken the rock and I've washed it, let it dry. I put two coats of black paint on it so it'll stand out really nice. So it's basically just like slate. And now I'm just deciding which side to use. This side's a little more flat, but this side has a nice little bit of a texture to it. I think we'll use this side. You know, what do you think there? It's got this little line here. And I think by allocating it this way down, it'll look really good. So I'm gonna put this in the machine. And we'll try to level it up as much as possible. If not, if we can't get it level, then we'll have to use curved surface, okay? Let's put it in the machine. All right. Put it in the machine. And I like this side the best. First thing we'll do, let's put the level on here. Well, it's not bad, not bad. This way, a little bit off there. Yeah. Oh yeah, a little bit off there, a little too high. So I'm going to raise that up. What I like to do is, I used to do laminate flooring, and I have these little plastic wedges. I like to stick those up. They help out a lot. So I'll stick them in. And get it as level as possible. There. Oh yeah, much better, much better. Oh, that's a little high there. It's a little low here now. So we'll put that over here. Put one over here. A little higher here. There we go. Not bad.
Not bad, not bad. I'll stick one in the back here. Just a... make it more sturdy. Now, let's... gonna line up the front flat here. All right, not bad. That's not bad. We got it pretty level. So now let's go make a design. All right, so we've opened our X tool creative space. Let us pick up the height of our piece. First, make sure it's connected. Yep, she's connected. Let us pick up the height. We're going to mark off our area. We'll use polygon. That way we get a nice big area. We're going to start with the top. And we'll end it there. So this is our area we have to work with. Now we will be putting in the number house address. And since we're going to engrave that, I'll put it on a boulder so I can fill it in. That right there. Let's see if we should make it bolder. Yeah, we'll make it nice and bold. There we go. And let's put a little saying in here. And what better saying than, let's see, home, sweet home. All right, we'll make that bold as well. Nicely like that. Let's throw in a picture. Nice picture of a deer. I like that better. save that. Maybe head down there a little bit more. All right. I like it. Let's, we'll save this off. We'll call it home. Now, I'm not sure about the home sweet home. You know, I think we can make that look nicer. There we go. I like that. Now, we're going to set the material as slate. Rock coaster. And we're going to use that for our settings. Now, for our first set of settings, all we're going to do is we're going to score it to see how it looks. The picture, we won't output it yet. All right. So, let us frame it in. Go to frame. Doesn't look too bad. And let us score it and see what happens. And off we go. Frame. All righty. Doesn't look too bad. And let us score it and see what happens. Off we go. The scoring didn't come out too bad. Let us try and engrave it now. I think we're going to slow it down for the engraving just a little bit. And start.
Okay, that doesn't look too bad. Gonna need some cleaning up.
All right, let's go do the diagram. Picture of
the deer. Framing it in. Looks good. Let us do the picture of the deer.
Alright, let's see the picture of the deer.
Oh, not bad at all.
Alright, let's take it out. We'll have a look at it and see what we get.
Alright, let's take it out and have a look at it.
Oh, as you can see, it didn't come out too bad. We're gonna go wash everything off and then we're gonna clear coat it, and when that dries we'll bring it back and have a look at it. Okay, stick around.
Okay, so I've cleaned her up, washed her off, and we got a couple coats of clear coat on, and here's what we have. It came out very nice. Not too bad. This is an easy project. This is a beginner project. You just have to find the stone. Simple as that. And like I said, this is a home address I made for my neighbor. And it's going to be a late Christmas present. Of course, I'm always behind. Well, and I hope you enjoyed it. You can make, like I said, home addresses. Pet memorial stones, a nice saying for your garden, you know, the gnome lives here, whatever, and so on and so forth. Whatever your imagination takes. Like that, this is all about imagination too. Testing, imagination, and a lot of fun. This is a lot of fun. All right, till next time, Johnny Laser. Talk to you later. I'm going to go back to the market.